where a lot of kind of where Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu became famous is from the guardrails, like the early UFCs. You know, the hoist using this to get chokes, arm bars, and things like that. This is why there's a lot of emphasis in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Mark's going to play a close guard, so behind the back, his feet across like this, because this gives him a lot more control. Yeah, so if Mark takes his knees to nose, let's cross and then knees to nose, then he can break my posture. And this is the biggest part of Jiu-Jitsu, okay, especially in guard. I'm trying to keep my posture, Mark's trying to break my posture, so if you pull your knees in again and do that. Yeah, so from here, you can start hooking my arms, you can start doing things to go for arm bars and triangles and things like that, okay? So, what we're going to do, Matt's going to overhook my arms, so both arms, that's it. Yeah, I'm just going to wiggle my arms out. He's not putting too much resistance in, I'm in this low position. Yeah, hand on the belly, posture up, okay? I'm not leaning back, yeah, so your head should be in line with your hip. This is really important. As soon as I start going back here, he can do some of the cool stuff, like a hip bump, Kimura, and guillotine stuff. Yeah, so I'm keeping this good posture. Yeah, I'm creating a big base here as well. Yeah, so there's lots of weight distributed across a larger surface area, which makes me more stable. So we've gone from a twig, yeah, a little bit of pressure on here, to a big tree. Okay, controlling the hand, controlling this posture by putting my hands on the belly. Okay, so here your knees to nose. He wraps over. Yeah, I'm just going to work out. Yeah, and get my posture. Now this time when he does his knees to nose, don't work as easy because I can use my hands. Yeah, to keep the control. Does that make sense? Okay, let's do that a couple of times just so we have a feel, and then we'll start looking at how we move around the guard and break the guard up. Alright, so we usually do a thing where after we finish hooks, why are we getting our arms out, why are we controlling the belly, stop them from being able to pull us down using those knees. Does that make a little bit of sense? Okay, so let's look at how we open the guard up now and do some of the cool stuff. So, yeah, I've got my posture. Yeah, he tries to bring me down and break my posture. I've got my hands controlling here. I like to have my hands slightly on an angle. Yeah. My hands are here. It's easy for a man to come on the inside and do like a big karate. Yeah, to clear the hands. I take my hands on a slight angle, he tries to do the same, I can usually keep at least one hand when he tries to do that, okay? So, I need to change my body position, so we're going to go into what's called L-shape, okay? So I'm going to stick one knee into the bottom, and then I'm going to take the other knee out, so I'm creating an L. Now you see how he stretches his legs out, okay? This is really important for opening the gap, yeah? Because he's in a closed guard at the moment, alright? The way that I like to do this is I put my hand, if it's a gi, rip the pants. If he's not got a gi, put your hand on the knee, yeah, and push the knee down to the mat to open the guard. Yeah. As soon as I get into this position though, I'm going to what's called combat base. Yeah. So leg here in this position. This gives us the opportunity to do some different passes, but because you guys are all strikers as well, stand up. Yeah. So if you like kicking and hitting people, which I'm sure you do, yeah, you don't want to be playing ground stuff, if you're doing it for mixed martial arts, you need a way of getting out of the guard. And this is a good way of doing it, okay? So here, I've got my, we'll do the full thing, so knees to nose, wrap over. Yeah, hands on a slight angle, knee to the bum, knee out, stretches his legs out, on top of the knee, push down, into this position, yeah, combat base. Have a little practice of standing, get up. With mixed martial arts and self-defense and stuff, it's really important as you stand to cover your face, yeah? So if I get into this habit of coming here, you can kick me in the head. Okay, so you always want something covering your face, yeah? Make sense? So with that mark, it looks like this. So I've got my posture, knee to butt, down, then sit my weight down. Hand on the knee, push the knee down. If it's got a gi, grab the gi pad, put it down. Bring your knee into this position, it's combat base. Okay?
Where have we got our hands together?
Yeah. So if you're standing, just there, yeah. Because a lot of people get into the habit of not really thinking about the kicks and stuff. In mixed martial arts, As soon as I go to here, I get kicked in the head. It's okay for that person to kick me up in the head. It's called 3 points of contact. So if I do this, I've got 3 points of contact, they can't kick me in the face. For the street, they can kick you in the face anyway, so you might as well protect your face. So there, just cover your face up, step away.
All right, good to go.
One, two, three.